end is near. And so I
face. Italian immigrant chef riveted the culinary spotlight on Greater St. Louis. Andreino DeSantis had stars from all over the world flocking to his little restaurant on the hill.
Yeah, and after going on to further fame and fortune in California, he returned to St. Louis recently to relive some old times. And his reunion with his friends here produced plenty of great food and yet another topic for Pavel and Lawrence.
Most of the stars didn't understand about food, but nevertheless, they're good people.
Andreino DeSantis should know he's probably fed more of them than anybody else in the world. It was his uncle Alfredo who started the family tradition in Rome with the legendary Fettuccine Alfredo. Mary Pickford and Douglas Fairbanks Jr. found Alfredo, sang his praises. At 22, Andreino decided to bring his family's classic dishes to America. He made it to St. Louis about 1960 and began, humbly enough, as a waiter at Tony's.
I started cooking because I couldn't find the food in America I liked it. And I didn't know it was hereditary, it was from my family. And I started cooking different than anybody else. So I have my own particular way.
In 1961, Andreino got a $400 tax refund. That was enough to make a down payment on this restaurant on the hill, which is now Dominic's. It was then owned by Yogi Berra's father. With his engaging personality, wit, and ability to break into song, Andreino soon became the darling of the dining denizens here. Everybody was writing stories about him. His pictures were everywhere. People like Frank Sinatra and Dean Martin, who ate at his uncle's restaurant in Rome, took a liking to Andreino, and Andreino soon became chef to the stars. Gussie Bush considered Andreino his personal chef. Andreino is full of personal stories about the rich and famous, like the late Cary Grant, who he says, forgot to tip me. Andreino left St. Louis in 1981 to open exclusive restaurants in Palm Desert, California.
Well, Andreino was in town this time for a series of cooking classes at the Dierberg supermarkets. He's traveling all over the world these days, consulting and creating new recipes, maybe another one someday to rival Fettuccine Alfredo. Andreino, by the way, has already earned the title King of Fettuccine in America, and something tells me he's going to wear that crown for a long time to come. That's Obel at Large for this moment. What has he got? If nothing left, then he has not. Not to say the things that he truly feels, and not the words of someone who lives. Let the record show, I took all the glory.